A tattoo is for life, so you really want to get it right.
Yes, but it's important the price is right too. So you'd think setting a strict budget would do the job, wouldn't you?
Every tattoo tells a story, but some have a plot twist that's unexpected.
Do you like it?
No regrets.
Dan just wanted to be sure his story would end perfectly, because as with all tamoko,
I do have Māori in my family.
The meaning behind his was deeply personal.
There's the meeting of two souls, which is me and Kayla, in new life. So Lockie, my son, my friend Cody that passed away. So yeah, from brain cancer. And then my traits, pretty, I guess, loving and care about things deeply, yeah.
So he really cared when he didn't get what he expected.
The bottom here isn't finished, up to there, and then the top is actually meant to come up to about halfway.
And that he felt misled by Zealand Tattoo in Queenstown.
It wasn't worth what they charged me for it, and then it wasn't agreed upon with the two sessions.
But let's go back. Kayla and Dan are busy. Dan works long hours as a mechanic and he's training as a fire and emergency volunteer. Kayla juggles keeping her own dog grooming business going, keeping Lockie well fed, and well, just keeping up.
Doing all my invoicing, online groceries and everything else that you don't have time for.
They live in Gore and it's rare they get away, but the chance came for a weekend break and to both get the tattoos they'd planned for so long.
We had a voucher from my parents to stay in Queenstown, so finally we found a weekend that worked for my parents to look after Lockie.
Short of time and money though, they had strict criteria to have the tattoos done in a single setting and to stick to budget, especially as back then Kayla had injured her arm.
I'm self-employed, I don't get paid sick days.
Kayla found one studio, but it couldn't take them both.
Like, quite full, especially with it being, it was meant to be a full day session.
So for Dan, she came across Zealand Tattoo. The reviews looked great and
Zane seemed very willing to help. I was like, wow, these people are really, you know, they really want to get this done for Dan.
So she discussed the budget with manager Zane Swanston by email. As with many studios, no definite quote, but Kayla agreed to a deposit of $100 and bought a voucher for $1,000. Saying a few hundred dollars more on the day was the most they could afford.
I feel like I had stressed the budget multiple times. I was under the understanding, the impression that Dan was going in, that Dan was going to walk out with a complete piece.
So off they went, having booked Dan in, a decision they were about to regret. Once there, Dan says he was persuaded to top up the voucher to $1,400. In total.
You thought that was for the whole thing?
Yes, I did, yeah.
But about 2 hours later,
he just said, oh, one more line to go on it and then I'm finished for today. And I was like, I don't think so.
It's not $1,400 worth. It's absolutely not.
I asked him, what would it cost me to finish it then if this is what it's cost to get to this point? And he said, you'd be paying anywhere between $2,500 to $3,200.
Confused, Dan left and rang Kayla.
I was like, wait, what? Like, I was honestly in disbelief. Of course, I was like, typing, absolutely not, go back in,
He did.
He said, you either have to come back for another session and pay more, or, yeah, you just won't get your money. And I said, I'm unsure if you will see me for another session, but, yep, and then just left.
I guess yeah. That's as angry as Dan gets, isn't it?
I was so gutted for Dan. It was just meant to be something that was so special for him, and for someone to just completely disregard that, yeah, that really pissed me off.
Because this is Dan's unfinished for $1,400 and Kayla's finished on the day for $300 less. Now, prices will vary, so we checked with a few studios and most said $1,000 to $1,500, but for a finished, filled-in shoulder tamoko, depending on size. Kayla felt Zealand Tattoo had misled them and the customer care was terrible. Others told Fair Go that too. Like Courtney Daniel saying she was originally quoted $400 but asked to pay $750. She doesn't even like the result. Elliot Chan says he was told he'd only get a bubblegum sticker for his $500 coupon gift card and that he could cry about it if he liked. He stuck to $500, got 45 minutes and this, which at least he likes. And on Zealand's Facebook, more bad reviews. Kayla added hers.
And he blocked me.
So she emailed.
We sent that 2 days after the session and it's coming up 3 months ago now, and yeah, we We had not heard anything.
So she took Zane Swanston to the disputes tribunal. He got a letter about it.
So then all of a sudden, we get this email.
He offered a $500 refund, falsely claiming they'd agreed a price and gave no apology.
An apology is what they were after, so rather than accept the offer, they came to fair go. We got in touch with the manager. No 3 months wait for us, he got back to us the same day with another confidential offer and to say it was a misunderstanding. But what they wanted was accountability.
Would have been really nice for him to agree to talk to you and just apologise. And I would have loved to hear him say, I'm going to change the way I run my business.
But with no change in sight, they're accepting the money and speaking out, warning others to be very wary of pricing with Zealand Tattoo.
Fair go is going to be enough, hopefully, to make people aware.
So how did your tattoo go?
No, I don't even have my ears pierced. That's how, like, not okay with needles I am.
We may be the last two people in New Zealand that don't have tattoos.